Good morning and welcome to St. John's Every Day. My name's Pam Coles and I'm continuing our readings from Paul's letter to the Philippians, chapter 1, beginning to read at verse 22. As long as I'm alive in this body, there's good work for me to do. If I had to choose right now, I hardly know which I'd choose. Heart choice, the desire to break camp here and to be with Christ is powerful. Some days I can think of nothing better. But most days, because of what you're going through, I'm sure that it's better for me to stick it out here. So I plan to be around a while, companion to you as your growth and joy in this life of trusting God continues. Paul, as we know, was in jail, and at any moment he might have been called upon to lay down his life. But it didn't seem to make any difference. We might expect that of someone who'd met Jesus. But to what extent have we adopted Paul's attitude to life and death in this present time? I share with you one man's story who, when faced with innumerable medical problems in his life, would often say, "Whether I live or die, I can't lose either way because of Jesus." He'd been a sick child and had caught rheumatic fever, which left him with a damaged heart at a time when replacement heart valves were unheard of. But he left a fairly normal life and went to college to learn to be a craft teacher. And he met his future wife at school, and their marriage was really quite poignant when it came to those vows about sickness and health. He began to train as a priest in 1977. He completed the course, but not before undergoing heart surgery to replace two valves. He eventually became a team vicar, and then he moved to his own parish. And without any warning, he was told his valves were leaking. So off to LGI and surgery again, though he said it was as easy as shelling peas this time compared with 8 years before. Then back to ministry and another parish from which he retired in 2004 and came here to St John's to help where he could. In 2006 he needed more heart surgery. He said, "I don't know how things will go. The first time was very difficult, the second easy. This time God only knows. And in that, I'm content and at peace." He returned, thank God, to praise God for his faithfulness and to continue his ministry, mainly with the elderly. 2011, he was diagnosed with prostate cancer that had spread to his bones and was too advanced that nothing could be done. And at this point, I confess that he was my husband. And I remember reminding the consultant of Jeff's oft-time declaration about living and dying, mainly for the benefit of a Muslim nurse present at the time. Jeff was told, and he said to me, "Do you know, I can't remember the last time that I felt so peaceful." And he died peacefully 5 days later with our three sons with us. And of course we wept, for grief is the price that we pay for love. But we had a wonderful funeral, an extended time of praise and worship, to celebrate Jeff's life, yes, but more importantly, to celebrate Christ's victory over death and the life in all its abundance that waits for all who believe. Thank you.